On the bill.
Senator Breslin on the resolution.
Hopefully I'll confine my remarks generally to the upstate area, but we in upstate really look forward to those economic councils. The first time we have a lieutenant governor from upstate, first stripped of his authority, some of his authority as a lieutenant governor, and now $130 million, which we thought would have been used for upstate economic development, is gone from the picture. Hopefully we can move to restore that later. And when I look around, I see that in the budget, the addition of New York City OTB, something that the majority voted against this past summer when that was a major issue, last summer. And that OTB bill for New York City that's been placed back in the budget, to me, affects upstate again in a negative way. It affects Saratoga. It affects Naira. It affects the harness track at Saratoga, and not very good for us in upstate. I look forward in this budget to really being responsible. I sat here in the minority for 12 years arguing we should do more for upstate economic development. I don't see it in this budget resolution put forward by the majority. And again, upstate languishes and suffers. I don't see anything in this budget on UB 2020. Again, major, major part of upstate. Also, I would have been delighted to see the University of Albany be included in that as well. And there's minor parts of this budget that trouble me. I look at, when we're all one New York, as Senator Smith said, we're not upstate, we're not downstate, we're not Democrat, we're Republican. And I look at the Environmental Protection Fund, and it lists open space programs. The governor put forth certain sums of money, and really kept them at the levels they were in the past, and I applaud the governor for doing that. And I go down, and program after program after program in the open space program, the Senate majority leaves intact, with one exception, that being an open space program that happens to be located in my district. Probably a coincidence, the Albany Pine Bush. Hopefully, at a later point, that will be restored. But again, it's the lack of emphasis on upstate, the lack of recognizing the fact that we in upstate have suffered for so many years. We've been cast aside, and we need that economic development. It's not present here. And I hope before April 1st, with the help of my Democratic minority, that we will be able to do more for upstate, do more for economic development, to do more to resurrect what's an area that has been languishing for many, many years. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Breslin.